Hello and welcome to all. In this video session, we will learn about SAP purchase order cycle. So these are steps in purchase order cycle in SAP. First, we create a purchase order in ME21N transaction code. We transmit this purchase order to our vendor. Then vendor dispatched material to our plant, which is mentioned in our purchase order. Our plant persons, after checking of quality and quantity of the material which is mentioned in the purchase order, create a goods receipt in transaction code MyGo. Goods receipt is a confirmation that whatever material and quantity which we have mentioned in the purchase order has been received in our plant. So after creating goods receipt, we have to pay to vendor. So we have to make a payment to our vendor. So for this, we have to create our invoice document in MyRO transaction code. So these are three steps for purchase order cycle in SAP. So in this video part one of purchase order cycle, we will learn how to create a purchase order and how to transmit a purchase order to a vendor. Now we will do practicals. So this is our SAP EasyAccess screen, and now I will show you the menu path first. SAP menu, logistics, materials management, purchasing, purchase order, create, and ME21N create. So either we can double click on here, or else in the command box we can put our transaction code ME21N. Both ways we can do. So I have put this transaction code ME21N and click on the green button to enter. Now this is a transaction code. This is a screen to create a purchase order. Initially, when we enter into ME21N transaction code, you will look like the screen like this. All the data will be in a closed position. So basically, in purchase order, we have three types of data. First is header data, second is item overview data, and third is item details data. We will discuss this in a minute. So first, an important thing while creating a purchase order is we have to enter our vendor. So if we are aware about our vendor, then we can straight away enter our vendor code over here. If not, we can click this find button, so that we'll ask the system to find a vendor. So in the name column, I will give say ABC star. So I'm asking our system to show me the list of the vendors will start by ABC. So I have put here ABC star. So continue. So the system has shown us the list of vendors which start by ABC, 10 entries form. So right now we will select one vendor, ABC raw material supplier 401355 is a vendor code. So double click on this. So now we have select our vendor. So to accept the vendor, we can press the enter, or we can click on this green button. Effect will be the same. When we click on the green button or when we press the enter button, then after that system will pull the data for this vendor into purchase order. I will show you this. So click on this enter button. Now see, system has shown us the error message like enter purchasing organization. Automatically our cursor moves on to this field, purchasing organization, in organization data tab. So here we have to mention our purchasing organization. So I here put 1000 as our purchasing organization, purchasing group as 100 and company code as 1000. Okay, so now see, when I click on this enter button, after we enter our vendor, then system pull the vendor detail. I will show you that. So I will click on this address tab. Now see, this is the address which we have maintained at the time of creating our vendor. So system has pulled that address. Now second thing, I will click on delivery slash invoice tab. So this is Incoterm. These Incoterms we have mentioned at the time of creating our vendor master. So system has pulled that data. Okay. Now see one more thing. I will expand this item overview button. There is the same button to expand and to close, that is collapse. Now let us say we want to create a purchase order for 100 line items, and for that you want a particular field as a default field, so you don't need to enter that field again and again while creating the purchase order, so that you can save your time at the time of creating purchase order. So I will click on this personal settings button. Now see, in personal settings button, select default values. There are two tabs, PO header tab and purchase order item tab. So in PO header tab, we can default our document type. This is our document type. In our next coming videos, we will discuss about this document type. So right now our document type is standard PO, that is NB document type. We can also set our purchasing organization, purchasing group, company code as default if required, so that we don't need to enter the data every time. Okay, so if we click on this more field button, see there are more fields like terms of payment, currency, Incoterms, etc. These fields also we can set as a default at the PO header level. I will click on the purchase order item tab. So here we can default some fields like item category, account assignment category, plant. Right now I have default our plant. Our plant code is, we are using is 1000. So I have default this plant. So we don't need to enter plant for every line item. Okay, storage location, material group, requisitioner, etc. I will click on the more fields button. So again, price list, Incoterms, season, all these fields we can set as a default field at purchase order item level. So right now I have default item category as standard and plant as 1000. So we don't need to enter these fields at the time of creating purchase order. So this is how we can default a field at the time of creating purchase order while creating purchase order. Okay. So now in the material column, we have to give our material. So I will click on the find button. In material description, I will put say laptop star. So I want a list of the material which start by laptop, the word laptop. Continue. Laptop cover, let's say I will select laptop cover, double click on laptop cover. Purchase order quantity, how many quantity we want to order from our vendor. Here now don't need to put plant. Why? Because in personal settings I have already set our plant as a default plant. Now press enter. So the system will pull the material master data. Now, so we have entered this first line item. We will enter second line item. So hard disk, I will click on the find button. Hard disk star. Hard disk 1 TB, double click. We need fire quantity and it's okay now. So we are creating purchase order for two line items. So here we can select the required line item to see the details of that particular line. So right now first line item is active. So in delivery tab we will discuss about some important fields. There is first over delivery tolerance. We have to mention in percentage. So what is over delivery tolerance? Say if we have mentioned 10% in over delivery tolerance, then what will happen? Let us say we raise a purchase order for 100 quantity. Okay, and we have mentioned over delivery tolerance as 10%. Now at the time of taking goods receipt, system will accept the quantity up to 110. Why? Because we have mentioned 10% as our over delivery tolerance. As against to over delivery tolerance, there is a field for under delivery tolerance. Let us say we raise a purchase order for 100 quantity, and under delivery tolerance we have mentioned as 10%. So system will accept at the time of goods receipt, system will accept up to 90 quantity. Okay, why? Because we have mentioned the under delivery tolerance as 10%. Or if we activate this unlimited, then system will not check any, system will not check quantity, and we raise a purchase order for 100 quantity, then we can take a GRN for 150 quantity also. Why? Because 150, 200, any quantity. Why? Because we have taken on this unlimited. So right now I will not tick on this. Okay, then stock type. What is stock type? At the time of taking GRN for this particular line item, because our first line item is active right now. We are in the first line item. So for this first line item, our stock type will be unrestricted use at the time of taking goods receipt. So we can select from here unrestricted use or quality inspection or block stock. Movement type for unrestricted use is 101 at the time of taking goods receipt. Now first reminder, second reminder, third reminder, if you want to send the reminders to our vendor, then here we can mention the number of days. Then GR processing time. GR processing time is a number of days we require to take or to create a goods receipt. Okay, then there is a field for delivery completed. So I will tell you the use of this field. Let us say we have created a purchase order for 100 quantity, and out of this 100 quantity, vendor has dispatched only 90 quantity. But afterwards, vendor has informed us that he will not deliver the balance 10 quantity. So the purchase order, current status of the purchase order is, the purchase order is pending for 10 quantity, but vendor has informed us that he will not provide or he will not supply the balance 10 quantity. Then in that case, we can click on this delivery completed indicator. Okay, so system will assume this purchase order, or system will treat this purchase order as completed, although there is a balance quantity in the purchase order. So this is the use of this delivery completed indicator. So now I will click on the print preview button, so that system will show us the, yeah, this is a standard print preview for the purchase order. We can change as per our requirement with the help of our programmers. Okay, so this is a standard print preview for the purchase order. Now I will click on the check button. So system will check for any errors. So no messages issued during check, so no errors. Now we can save the purchase order. So I will click on the save button. So then system will give us the purchase order number. So standard purchase order created under number 45001820204. So 45001820204 is our purchase order number. So we have created our purchase order. Now we want to transmit this purchase order to our vendor. So to transmit, first of all, I will create a new session. So I will click on this button to create a new session, and I will follow the following menu path: SAP menu, logistics, materials management, purchasing, purchase order, messages, ME9F, print/transmit. So double click on this ME9F, print/transmit. So this is the last purchase order number. If we require some different number than this, we can put our required number, or we can click on the find button to find our purchase order number. Okay, right now we require this number, so we will not change it. Click on the execute button. Now select and click on the output message, so that system will, now system has created a PDF file and transferred to our output device, that is printer LP01. So this is how we can create a purchase order, and we can take a print of the purchase order and send to vendor through email or any other mode. So that's all for now in this video. Thank you for watching.